Good morning, everybody. Good afternoon. All right, we've been here since 5:30 this morning, getting unloaded. Took a whole lot longer than I anticipated. But what we're going to do is, apparently, the address they give me on my load info is for the Flying J over in Tampa. I hadn't called the broker yet, but I'll call him when we get over there and see what's what. Give me just a minute, we'll be pulling out of here. I'm gonna do this time lapse from Orlando to Tampa, I think. Maybe. I'm trying to. Yeah, it's Flying J and TA right there at the same spot, 75 miles from here. So, Tasha's still asleep, so we'll just do a real quiet all aboard. I charged my GoPro battery up this morning while we were sitting and waiting. Then I unplugged it was like at 98%. So apparently it's one of the bad batteries because when I turned it on just now it was at 44%. I bet that would be a nice spot to fish in right there. I bet you there's all kinds of fish in that. Yep, I've ended up having to sit 14 hours before waiting for a tow truck. Joe, for any amount of time, one day you'll have to wait for one. Now we're leaving the delivery. We're going to the next pickup. But it's not scheduled till tomorrow to pick up. I'm gonna call them when we get over to the Flying J. I'm gonna call the broker and see if we can pick up today or tomorrow, which one. And then plus I've got to get the actual address to the place. Might be in the wrong lane, I don't know. We'll have to open up the door when we get up here. And of course, I always go into the wrong lane. I'm not 100% sure how it's got us routed. Looks like it's 528 toll over to 4 and then down. Good morning, Denise. And they did have a staging lot that I think we could have come to last night. But I wasn't sure, so that's the reason why I stopped where it is. Good morning, good morning, good morning, gang. How are we all doing today? I'm gonna see if the time lapse, well, hopefully it'll run. I'm just gonna run it from Orlando to Tampa. I don't know how many minutes that'll use up, but We'll see when we get there. Hopefully it don't overheat because I had to plug it up. On account of it, I don't know, my battery. I didn't turn it on, so I don't know why. I know there's one of my batteries ain't no good. You put it in and it eats up the life no matter what. And apparently, two of them do. One doesn't that I know of. Which is the one I normally keep in it. But it's hard to tell. I forget which one's which with the black bottom ones. And it looks like that's about as light as we're going to get it with overcast. But I do know that we got to get an empty weight at the Flying J. Like I said, though, I don't know. I'm not real sure why we put our addresses to the Flying J. Unless it was just because of, maybe I didn't read it all. I'm good for that. One good thing about putting a GoPro sun visor is I can run the defroster and keep it somewhat cool. We're on 528 tow road right now. Which when we come in this morning, there's the airport. I don't know if it was right before the airport or right after the airport where I seen the all the multiple colored lights. Look like Ferris wheels and stuff. I'm not real sure. Airport sits right on the highway, though. Yeah, it's 528. Oh, there went a jet. Just now shot up to there. Got another one fixing to go. They're going the opposite way, though. How you doing, Velociraptor? Doing pretty good. Been up all morning, but you know, still doing pretty good. Or let's say 50-50. Maybe 25-75, I don't know. Not bad though. And for them now. We're not to 4 yet, but we're headed that way. I think we're headed that way. Oh, they're out there skiing and everything over at that water park. center a bicycle lane? I'm kidding. God. Well, I would get over there in the other lane and go up a little bit more, but that left lane ends and looks like it says a mile, and you know, trucks aren't supposed to be in the left lane. And if you hadn't hit that thumbs up button, go ahead and do that for us, please. Does not bring you out of the lurker's lounge. Keeps you right there, safe and sound in it. We could possibly hit 100 likes before we get to Interstate 4. We've only went 11 miles. See, that's what I don't miss about East Coast driving. No, I was kidding when I said, is that a bicycle lane out there beside us? But for real, is it a motorcycle lane? Hello, Rachel. Welcome to the game. Go on. Are you saying yes, that that is motorcycle lane? Yeah, I would get over in that other lane, but I don't want to get no ticket for being in the third lane when that one runs out. It'd be my luck. I have gotten them before. Wow, I wish I'd have seen that earlier. I would have got over anyway. He's got by his sunroof. See if I can get over. I don't think I can. There's too much traffic coming now. By the time I can get over, it's going to be backed up over here. I'm not going that way. Looks like that's everybody's exit. For real. That's backed up on the other side like that too. What's on this exit that everybody likes? Ah, I see a theme park over there. Every day, 10-4 on that. Alright, we're gonna get up here on this 4 west. Maybe we won't hit no more traffic delays, I don't know. Florida, I wouldn't get nothing done but fishing. That'd be it. I think. SeaWorld.
Thank you.
How you doing this morning, Ryan? It's the first time we've been to Florida in about 3 or 4 years, I'm guessing. I'm not quite sure if we're going to be spending the night in Tampa or if we're going to get our load picked up today and then turn around and head towards Tennessee or head to Tennessee. I think it's Shelbyville is where we're going. Yeah, I don't care much for them things. Just on occasion. And we got 52 miles to the Flying J down here. I forget the actual name of the town location. Gatorland. I hadn't seen any Gatorland signs. Looks like Mickey Mouse over there holding up power lines, though. That is right. That. How you doing, Foster App? vehicle. Of course, you know, being... I'm not gonna say it. Oh, they're just gonna do their best to keep me stay right in front of me. Don't wanna speed up, but don't want me coming around. Man, the traffic on the other side's thick. Uh-oh. Got audio buffer. Completely unacceptable, but I'm just here to tell you, in the trucking world, when it comes to waiting on tow trucks, is there's never ever a set time or easy time to sit and wait on them. I've waited 8 hours for them to bring me fuel before. I've waited 14 hours for a tow truck to come and tow me. It happens. It's just part of trucking. That's part of it. So, you can't do nothing but accept it, no matter who you are, or where you are, or what you're doing. Yeah, I waited 8 hours for fuel. I was 5 miles from my fuel stop. The company would not let me fuel in town because it wasn't in the fueling network. And I ended up running out of fuel before I got to the first pilot, 5 miles from it, and sat there on that on-ramp for 8 hours of waiting for somebody to bring me some fuel. You're talking about like in the median? I think it's pretty neat. I like seeing them. I like seeing trains run like the medians of the interstates and stuff. And there was one time I waited 4 hours for a tow truck to come and pull me 4 inches because I got stuck. That's all he had to pull me was 4 inches up so that I wasn't stuck no more. And I waited 4 hours for that one. Yeah, but I mean, you know, we also have to take into consideration that if you've ended up waiting that long, for one, it's simply because the company didn't cancel that call and call somebody else. That, you know, that makes a big difference right there. And then two, usually those tow truck drivers that's coming to get you, they're usually, you know, already grabbing somebody up or already got somebody on their hook, you know, moving them. And it takes time. Tow truck workers do work hard, but really it falls all on the company when they let you sit and let you sit and let you sit and let you sit just because they don't want to cancel that call and call somebody else. Use somebody else. They want to grab the cheapest rate that they can, and usually the cheapest rate that you can in the tow truck business is the busiest tow truck that you're going to get. Yeah, that's one thing that I really hate about being out here doing this, because if something happens to you on the side of the road, it's usually going to take, you can just about get your 10-hour breakout by the time you get a tow truck to you. Not always, it don't always happen that way, but it happens that way a lot. Well, I mean, that's what I just said. I've waited 14 hours for a tow truck before to come and tow me. I've waited 8 hours for fuel, and I was 5 miles away from the fuel stop and waited eight solid hours for them to bring me fuel. Yeah, it's happened. I mean, if you drive truck for any length of time, it's going to happen to you. I had a blowout going out of Roanoke, not from the interstate, but going east out of Roanoke. I forget the highway highway numbers. I had a blowout up there one day, and I waited 7.5 hours for the tire repair guy to get there. Then when he got there, he was like, "Why not? You know, I can't change the tire right here on this emergency lane," which it was emergency lane just like what's right here. He said, "I'm going to need you to pull on up," which was half a mile to a store that wasn't a truck stop. It was just a store. Pull up into their lot so that I can change the tire, which knocked me out of the 30-minute or the 8-hour split break. So I sat there waiting for him 7.5 hours, and then turned right around from where he fixed my tire, which was a half a mile up the road, if that, and had to sit for another 10 hours and wait for my clock to reset. Yeah, 460. That's it. fantasy flight. But yeah, it all depends on your location, and like I said, it depends a lot on who the company calls and says, "Hey, I need to go pick this truck up," or "I need you to go do this for it." It just depends, because if they run for the cheapest rate in town, then that driver's going to be sitting there for a while. That's another reason why, if you've ever been running down the interstate and you see a truck driver driving with a blowed out tire, that's why they don't want to sit on the side of the interstate for 3 to 6 hours waiting to get the tire changed, if they can safely make it, you know, to the next truck stop and sit there and wait for the tire changed. Yeah. We got a bad overcast. I can't get the screen to brighten up any. Been trying to get it to brighten up for the last 15 minutes. I can't. It looks dark on my side, but I don't know exactly how it looks for y'all. Well, but then what that would do is that would just I don't know the best way to explain that. Just simply because there ain't really any way that they could make a law out of that. I'm not sure what we're picking up. It's being delivered to Walmart distribution, so some kind of food, I imagine. Yeah, we're picking up in the Tampa area. I forget the name of the actual little town that it is. I mean, you ain't gotta apologize. I'm just saying there really ain't. Really isn't a way to do that. It would be nice, though. I tell you what, they ought to put laws in place to where we don't have to sit at the shippers for more than 2 hours, and if we have breakdowns, the company has to get it fixed within two. It would be great, you know. It would be awesome. That's like back here at this delivery that where we just left from. I sat there for almost right at 6 hours getting unloaded. And that's crazy. Just it's insane. And I guess the time that we do lose out here on the road, sitting and waiting. Everybody always says driving my life away. It's not really driving my life away. It's more like waiting my life away out here on the road. Wherever you're at right now, go look if phone books still exist. Go look in the phone book at how many tow companies are in your town, and then, like Velociraptor said, then you have to find the companies that actually deal with the big trucks, because not any tow truck can tow a big truck. And not any tow truck driver can tow a big truck. So you don't have to have a special license to do the to be a tow truck driver unless it's you've got the bigger class tow trucks. not exactly sure. Like I was saying earlier, if we get to pick up today or if we have to wait till tomorrow. I'll find out when we get down here to the Flying J, but I'm going to go ahead and fuel up the truck again, which I don't need it. We got half a tank, but they want an empty weight, which generally means that they load it to weight. I'd rather unload it to a full tank of fuel weight as a half a tank of fuel. Have I heard of American Truck Simulator? Yeah. I've got it on my laptop. I don't play it that much. But it's a little more complicated on learning and building everything up than I originally anticipated when I started messing with it. Yeah, that's what I need to do is get the European simulator. It's the ETS. European Truck Simulator. I would never get that. I would never get the gist of it, that's what I mean by that. I do need to make some more ATS videos though. And then get the ETS, maybe make some of them videos. it's hard to wing it, cause I don't mess with it like when I'm driving or while we're out. I only do it while we're at home. And man, it's so time consuming trying to figure out everything, learn everything, and get all the stuff that you need. So I've just kind of like stopped messing with it. For now, anyway. Alright, we got 15 more miles to the Flying J up here. And I'm not sure if Devin has been here or not, but I know they asked yesterday. How long we was going to be up here. So I believe, we got a, that was actually the address they gave me for the pickup was the Flying J, but he told me yesterday that I was going to have to call the shipper. So I'm guessing, unless I just overlooked the address, looked at it wrong, I'm guessing I'll get the address from the broker. Not the shipper, but the broker. So we gotta stop and get a empty weight at Flying J. And then if we can't pick it up till tomorrow, then we'll be setting it to Flying J until then. If we can pick it up today, then we'll go ahead and go get it. Wherever it's at. Hello, Gene. How you doing today? comes to the heavy duty tow trucks, they generally run, you know, quite a distance in their within their radius. It's not saying that they don't go out of the 100-mile radius, but a lot of the heavy duty trucks do have to go out of their 100-mile radius because there's a lot fewer of them. How you doing, Devin? All right, sounds like a deal. I'm not sure the exact details yet. When I get up here, I've got to call the broker and find out if we can't get loaded today. We'll end up spending the night up here. Because I'm not even 100% sure where the pickup's at. They give me the Flying J address for the pickup. I don't know. I don't think I'm picking up from there. But we should know something here in about 20 minutes. What we're gonna be doing. Maybe 30 minutes. Because I'm going to get fuel and weigh the truck. And then I'm going to call them. Find out what's what with what. It's either Snailville or Shelbyville, Tennessee. I think it's Shelbyville. But you know, like I've said numerous times, I read the first, middle, and usually the last letter of the words, and it just occurred to me that there is a Snailville, Tennessee, so it could actually be Snailville, but I think it's Shelbyville. And then we should be running to the house after that. Yeah, Tennessee. Oh, hell. I better look and make sure. Yeah, we don't want to do that wrong state again thing. Was that last month we done that or month before last? It was last month, wasn't it? The last hometown. Yeah, I'll definitely give it another look, see, as soon as we get up here. Matter of fact, I'll do that as soon as we pull in the parking lot. Because, you know, it's one thing when you deliver, when you get to the, or when you go to the wrong address. Oh, look at that. What is that? Noah's Ark. Kind of looks like it could have been. Looks abandoned, though. I mean, it's one thing going to the wrong address than being like, oh, you're supposed to be on the other side of town. But, man, when you go to the completely wrong state, it's just like, wow. Yeah, we'll be going home from this load when we deliver this load, because it'll be our time for our home time. We'll drop this load out. That is, if I looked at the address right. And then we're not going to take 7 days like we normally do. I know I've said that the last three times, but we're not Definitely not taking 7 days this time. Because onion season should be kicked in by the time we get home. Do, I think, 3 or 4 days and then come off the home time. Onion season should be kicked in and onion season, heck yeah, I can't wait. Yeah, I think it was more than a red face moment there. I think my whole body was probably blushing. Because I just lagged around, you know, because I was like, oh, heck yeah, we got plenty of time. Woohoo! Yeah, which we had plenty of time. I had plenty of time, we could have made it to Louisville, Tennessee, which is not Louisville, Tennessee, it's Louisville. Even though it's spelled the same, it's pronounced different. Where we pick them up, we pick up the reds and the white. Forty-five minutes south of Sarasota. And from that, God, I'm caught behind this slow truck. Tons of traffic behind us. Oh, it's a truck being towed. I tell you what, even big trucks don't have no respect out here anymore. Good Lord, come on people, let me over. God. Jesus, that person shot out from behind me and still didn't let me over. Miles. Wow. That's a long drive. Yeah. And Florida driver and Tennessee drivers are pretty close to equal. I think there's just a lot more Florida drivers. Yeah, well, that's what I was thinking, is Shelbyville just outside of Nashville, but since you guys jogged my memory about the Kentucky deal, I'm definitely, way station open, I'm definitely going to take a relook, and plus the pickup, like I said, they had my pickup for the Flying J, and I know the Flying J is not where we're picking up at, I wouldn't think. Yeah, other side of the pond, 10 from that. I don't see no open or close sign. That's not right. Oh, wait, I did see an open sign. What am I talking about? I got too much going on inside my head right now. Good Lord, that cow was huge. And we got the bypass. That way station's like way back there. Dang. Deep in the holler. Alright, we're 2 miles away, I think, is what GPS says. They've got a little scale plate that runs across the lane as you're coming into the weigh station. Generally, if you're empty, not always, but generally if you're empty, they'll give you the bypass. But if your company is required to run across the scales, then they'll pull you on in, whether you're empty or not. Heck, I've been pulled into a closed scale before. And my GPS finally caught up. It was lagging, I think, its own self. You know, I don't know about the sun down here. I know the last time I was in Florida, the sun, it never did go away. Preschool prep fan, aka Noah. How you doing? Welcome to the gang. No trucks on Discovery Lane. This place looks like it's already full. Where's the scale at? I don't even see one. That's weird. Okay, I don't know. Well, man, my GoPro, I don't think recorded none of that. Dang it. Might have. Anyway. Tasha loves Florida too. Alright, let's see what we got here. Yeah, so they've. You must get an empty scale ticket before you go load. You will stage at Flying J and call with your ETA. Alright. So I guess we're going to hang out here. I still have to get the address and everything. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and get the fuel. I wonder where their scales are at. Anyway, I'll call them after I get the fuel. Oh, you know what? I forgot to look to see where it was going. It is going to Shelbyville, Tennessee. Appointment 5:24 at 2 a.m. Gotta love the Walmart appointments.
What's up, buddy?
Let's go.
Huh?
Weirdo.
Hi! Tasha's awake. You want something to eat from in here, or?
I'm just waking up. I don't want nothing to eat right now.
I'm gonna go back and get me a piece of pizza though. I'm starving. I've been up for hours.
Just in case.
Okay.
It's
Okay, screw over again, doggy. Screw over. What's the matter, buddy? All right, they don't have a scale here, so we have to go over to the TA and weigh.
Where are we at?
In Florida.
I know.
Sefner.
Far from Tampa?
We're just right out there. I guess we are in Tampa, like the Tampa Metro.
New load assigned.
One moment, please. I'll be right with you.
Thank you. It says it don't pick up till tomorrow. I've got to call. I'm gonna call them though and see. Yeah, exactly. That's what I was just sitting here thinking.
What?
This would be when the app would come in handy right now. But apparently they're too busy inside.
First way, everybody.
First way.
Truck number?
6.
Thank you.
see what the difference is in the parking spot. Sense to me.
to get down. I'm blowing that out. Move, move, get down, move. No, look at.
Thank you.
All right, now we're going to go on mute for a few minutes. I've got to call the broker and see if we can pick up the load today or if it's going to be tomorrow. Because if it's going to be tomorrow, I'm going to have to go back in and buy a reserve spot if they've got one. Yeah, exactly. Hurry up and wait. So give me just a few minutes here, and after we go on mute, it'll we'll have the sound back on in just a second.
back. That's why I always just hang up on people. Okay, I got another number to call, so we'll go back on mute for a few more minutes still.
Alright, well, I'm gonna walk back in here right quick and see if they've got a reserve spot available. If they do, I'm gonna buy a reserve spot. We'll be spending the night here. So, I'll be right back. Hurry up and wait. There you go. They got Popeyes and
Jeez, it's freaking hot out here. It is hot out there. Sheesh.
There's a seagull.
Look at that seagull. We got us a $25 reserve parking spot. How ridiculous is that?
Not ridiculous.
That's ridiculous.
Haber, can I have my seat?
The load's not gonna be ready till tomorrow.
No, doggy. Well, let's unattach and go to the ocean.
Been buffering or wasn't buffering, but we did meet Devin. Where I met Devin.
Who's Devin?
He's been coming to chat for a while.
I didn't get to meet him.
He wouldn't come over here.
Why? Oh.
Always awesome though when we get to meet somebody.
I was wondering who you was talking to.
Yeah. He humped his horn at me. I was like, what the?
So you didn't know you was gonna meet him? He was coming up here?
No, he said that he was getting off work at 2 o'clock and he would swing by, and I told him, well, just keep an eye out because I didn't know the details yet of how it was gonna work out. If we was gonna go straight from the Flying J to get loaded, or if we was gonna wait, or how he was gonna do, but he was here.
We're 54 minutes away from the ocean.
Yeah, yeah. I know my east and west about like I know my left and right. Not very good. I think I was 12 years old before I started putting my shoes on the right foot. And then it's not that I learned my right from my left. It's just that one's not comfortable and one is.
I still do that wrong with boots that aren't like when they're... Those snow boots I got, because they don't really have a curve in them until you put your foot in there and feel it, and then you realize, okay. But the little designs on them make me know that what foot to put them on, though.
Hey, I got me a new pair of shoes at the house, don't I?
Yeah. You're missing a part or a cover up.
And I still don't have an address on where we're picking up in the morning.
Isn't it a Publix?
No, that's where we deliver.
Oh. Why you need a Publix?
Because I'm going to look it up.
Look up what? I'll look it up.
Freight phones.
Huh?
Freight phone.
Frey?
Uh-huh. F-R-U-I, I guess.
See? only 130 miles from here, Bobby.
Distance. It's not pretty though. That's the only green one I've seen in the parking lot. So that's why when we first pulled in, I was like, why is he pulling out of that one parking spot into that parking spot when it's just four spots over? Because that entire row, I don't know, it don't make much sense to me, but this entire row to the left of us is not reserved parking. This entire back row that we're sitting on, the farthest row from the store, is reserved parking. I mean, how stupid is that? So that's why the dude, when we first pulled in, was pulling out of this spot and getting over in that spot, because he was getting out of reserved parking. And I thought I was going to do this a time lapse from Orlando to here, but I don't think it worked. I think because I plugged it in, it messed it up. That's what I'm thinking. Fixing to check it and see though.
Christopher Hill, the one that comes in the chat too. Yeah. From Tampa, though. He's from Tampa. Good Lord. Jesus. I'm running like in Colorado Springs.
God. That's outlandish. Sure did, and he said, tell Sonic Nick happy holidays. I don't know what he meant by that, but I said, I'm not sure that I know a Sonic Nick. He just gave me, you know, that weird laugh.
Huh? Wait, what?
Sonic said, did you say hi to Mickey for me? Florida's so bad they have to water their pavement. Man, it is muggy hot out there. I would much, as far as heat goes, I would much rather be in Texas as Florida.
No.
Yeah, as far as heat goes, I guess,
We don't live here one day. You're gonna have to deal with it.
It's just muggy here. See if I got it. pretty sure it didn't, but... We got four minutes right now. I might not have got the entire trip, but we got 4 minutes and 38 seconds worth of the trip. So let's see how far that goes. I really kind of like these time-lapse videos.
That's me right now.
I have figured one thing out about these time-lapse videos that, God bless, we went through that fast. Because whenever I do them, I'm going to have to stop and label them so that I know where I'm at, so I don't forget.
We'll probably catch a fish out of it. Pull up a snapper out of it.
And grab a snapper.
Those sound like they'd be good to eat, but they're probably not. Because I've never heard of them. People eating them. Just the sound of mangrove.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good. What's that little thing hanging in his mirror? Hanging where?
See where it stops at. Yeah, it didn't quite make it all the way. Looks like dice.
No, I'm talking about Hank's. It's stuck to the window.
Oh, it's a dash cam.
It's a little bitty.
It's probably a personal one that he's bought. Well, what I might do, that was pretty much just Orlando, almost to Tampa. Then I got Tallahassee yesterday. May just take them and put them together or something, I don't know. Jay says, snapper is good eating.
Cool.
I imagine they would be kind of similar to bluegill. Bluegill's actually supposed to, they're actually good. I always thought of them as like the saltwater bluegills. Well, our load's not due to pick up till tomorrow. So, yeah, we're just hanging out now. Hanging out till tomorrow. Swinging sticks and buzzing the greens golf. Hey, Doug. Welcome to the gang. I don't think I've ever seen your name in here. Done for the day. We'll get up sometime early in the morning and we'll start the live stream from here in the morning, I guess, which means that we'll live stream through the load. Might take a while, it may not, I don't know for sure. This load we're doing. deliver until Walmart, so the pre-recorded live that I plan on uploading across Lookout Pass and 4th of July Pass, or Independence Pass, whatever it is, when we get to that Walmart, I can actually upload that video, and then unlock it a little bit down, a little bit later down the road. Of course, all of our deliveries is going to be Walmart deliveries before too long. Is getting extremely hot, so I think what's up, Mickey Mouse? I think we're gonna go ahead and shut this one down, and we'll start it up before we take off in the morning. What do you think?
What?
Go ahead and shut the live stream off.
It's up to you.
It's up to me, she says. It's up to me, she says. First got together, she didn't cuss at all. She looked at me like you're crazy. She just played a nice innocent girl when we first got together. Thank you. out back there and watch some TV or something. And, the broker wanted me to call him at like 8 o'clock in the morning, so we'll start the live stream shortly after that, but before we pull out of here. So y'all have a great day. Appreciate you hanging out with us. And